a shout out to those in charge of episode 873 of One Piece tonight. They really did a good job of not only with the art style and the animation, but also they made an episode emotional with the Vince Mokes, who are pretty much emotional as when it comes to, I guess, pretty much the brothers, Ichiji, Yanji, and Neji. Sanji and Reiji are pretty much the exception, but for the most part, the Vince Mokes are German 66 for that matter, pretty much emotionless. So for this episode to be as emotional as it was, and I don't know if it was just the music or just the vibes, that this is the farewell, this is that conclusion, the closure for Sanji and his rest of his siblings. We don't know if we're going to see them again after this arc, we don't know. So I think that helped, and that helped because obviously it's a farewell, and it looks like it's going to be for good unless we go back to the Vince Mokes someday. There's so many loose ends that need to be tied up. I said that before. But like I said, shout out to those in charge behind this episode. Really great episode. And it starts off with brand new OST. By the way, there's multiple soundtracks, new soundtracks in this. So we start off with, I guess, Ichiji, Yanji, Neji, and Reiju protecting Sanji. They're like, yo, take the injured. And I love how it's Ichiji, yo, take the injured and get out of here. Just go. Sanji's like, what the hell are you guys doing here? Don't worry about us. We'll take care of this. We've got debt to repay for what happened at the tea party, so just go. Sanji uses Skywalk to try and get Luffy out of there before Sanji gets shut down, but I guess by some cannonballs. In comes Ichiji, Yonji, and Neji. And they use a technique called Black Bug, and I guess they repel the cannons that send right back down, so that's a cool little technique. By the way, the art style, the animation when they just flew up in the air picked up drastically. This is where Gemma gets to shine. And like I said, they have their own Gemma 66 theme music, so that's kind of cool. So Sanji's trying to Skywalk, just get the hell out of Dodge. I guess the whole episode is pretty much Sanji trying to get as close to the shoreline, away from the coast, so he can meet up with Sunny. While at the same time, you've got the Vince Mokes trying to do their thing. And you've got the Sunny coming into Coco Island, but they can't get too close, because obviously the fleet, although we do kind of see the fleet that was under the command of Snack, burnt to a crisp, thanks to, I guess, Judge, because we do get to see him in this episode, and I knew he was behind this. There has to, like I said, there has to be that closure between him and Sanji before the arc is wrapped. And I guess Smoothie's asked, should we worry about the fleet that's got taken down by Germa? And Smoothie's like, don't let them distract you. We've got to focus on the Straw Hats. Next episode, Smoothie's actually going to do something, so I can't wait to see what that is. I love how it's like Montdor must have been duped, like he must have been fooled, like we didn't know that already. And I love how talking to the Vince Mokes, like, what are you guys doing here? We thought you guys got taken down. The Gemma 66 got overtaken. No, you guys screwed up. So we tossed them into the sea. And Ubin's like, what the hell? And Montdor hears this, and because he's the one that got duped, obviously, like, how did this happen? They must have tricked me with the communications. They finally figured that out. But Tamago's the one that brings it to light. This is not just coincidence anymore. We've underestimated this group, and now we're paying the price for it. That's essentially what's happening. The movie calls Montdor out for being a douche, for like overlooking the Vince Mokes. I guess the movie kind of threw shade at Daifuku as well, because he failed against Carrot, so that was kind of funny. It's like shade being thrown all over the place when it comes to the Big Mom Pirates. Like, Smoothie's like, yo, you got fooled as well, and that you got Daifuku saying, oh, give me a break. It took me a while to catch up with you guys. So I was like, where the hell? In the previous review, where the hell was Daifuku? So that's kind of funny. I guess everybody's like on pins and needles, especially when the news broke out that Brulé just like she spilled the beans. Like, no, Luffy did not throw dirt in the eyes of Katakuri and just ran. No, that's not what happened. I'm going to tell you what happened. And as impossible as it may be to believe, Katakuri lost in the hands of Mugiwara. That Straw Hat Luffy took him down. Everybody hears this, including Montdor. And the rest, everyone's like, what the? Katakuri lost to this dweeb? So I love the expression everybody gives. And I'm pretty sure bounties are going to show up, because the last time we saw Big News Morgans and Stussy, they were next to Montdor. And if Montdor ever heard this, I'm pretty sure Morgans did too. So yeah, bounties are going to show up. That's going to hit the world government. So I think that's. And if it wasn't confirmed before, because Big News Morgans did take the shot of Big Mom falling from the top of the wedding cake a while back. So, yeah, So I think it's kind of obvious Barney's going to shoot up, but that's kind of cool. Everybody's reaction to Luffy being Katakuri finally, it's not like it wasn't a fluke, although a lot of people may th did think that that's the case. No, it's based on stamina and the fact that Luffy's the main character, that's how it goes. Just one concern when Sanji actually gets hit by a casual bullet, and then Oven gets ticked off. He's triggered, like, no, we cannot let Luffy leave here. The embarrassment, no, I'm going to kill him. Oven just darts right in front of the fodder, and boy, he's about to take out Sanji. But in comes Ichigo with sparking falconry. That's a cool little technique, by the way. He just blitzes not only some fodder, but also Oven as well. So that should give you a pretty good standpoint when it comes to power scaling. When it comes to Oven and Ichigo, then again, he did get off caught. Same thing with Sanji. He got, I mean, Sanji speed blitzed him and kicked him right in the face. Chiffon, so yeah, so it's crazy how the power scaling works, but that should give you an indication how strong Ichigo is. He lost the Katakuri, but boy, Oven paid for it. And Ichigo's looked like, no, go on, keep going, don't stop. So I love how when each of the Flint Smokes help out Sanji, they're doing it in their own casual way, characteristics. I mean, obviously, it is kind of cold-hearted the way they were treating Sanji, but you can't really bring all the fault to them because they were created that way. Like I said, Sanji and Reiji are kind of the exceptions to the rule, especially after this episode. Like, they're not a void to emotion. Flashback to when they were kids and they're tormenting Sanji. And with each, I guess, sibling that helps out, Sanji gets reminded of the terror he faced at the hands of Vince Max, but there was some light in the darkness. And it's the same thing with Nico Robin, with Reiji saying, you'll meet people who care about you, Sanji, so just go and don't come back. So it was the same thing with Robin. So I just love the dynamics there, the parallels are there. And then in comes Yonji with a technique called winch guillotine. So that's, I guess he extends his arm because he's made out of, I guess he's pretty much machinery at this point. So that's kind of cool. He takes his arm, extends it, uses winch guillotine to throw him right down. He busts up his muscles. So that was kind of cool. And like Yonji saying to Sanji, you're an eyesore, just get out of here. Kind of dash with Skywalk, and by the way, Sanji's like contacting Nami on the Dendamushi before all of this. It's like, we're on our way, so don't come any closer to the shoreline to Koko Island. So, but you've got Nami directing Sanji, like, just try and find an opening, but keep your distance. So that's kind of cool on their part. It's all about, like, again, it's all about Sanji, him putting in the work and making it to the Sunny. That's what this whole episode was focused on, and it took a teamwork dynamic of Gemma 66, the Vince Mokes of all people, the very people who tormented Sanji as a kid to help Sanji escape. So I just thought that was interesting parallels. And you knew Reiji was going to be the last one of the siblings, especially when the fodder around Commander Snack. Now, we didn't see Snack in this episode, but I'm pretty sure he's still around because he's a former Sweet General. So yeah, to have him off screen, no, I don't think so. Get taken down by Reiji. She uses Pink Hornet and she's like, anybody who tries to hit my little brother, obviously she's not in the in the front of a brother, so she can say whatever she wants. So that's kind of cool. I'm gonna hurt you. So that's kind of cool. And we get the emotional farewell between Reiji and don't let go of Luffy. And I love that quote. And I love the music they played. Oh, the heartstrings, bro. It's like, so, Reiji, I don't know what's gonna happen with you after this. Oh, but I hope we get to see you again. Just from in the past, as a child, she pushed Sanji away. She did it in present time. Push Sanji away. By the way, when Neji comes in as well, before then, uses Henry Blazer. He pulls out his light speed sword to be killed. So you're too slow. You need to work up on your speed. Just get out of here. And Sanji's like, yo, I didn't need ask for your help. He just throws a fastball with Sanji. He just throws him straight into the air, like some super strength type of deal. Accelerates his speed. Neji helped out before Reiji did, but you knew Reiji was going to be the last of the Vince other siblings to say goodbye. It just makes sense. And the parallels between the kids and what they are now is so, it's so cool to see. Like I said, the music they play with Reiji, great. And while she darts off, so farewell Sanji, and Sanji just smiles. And when Reiji goes into action, before she does that, she actually tears up. So to say that Reiji doesn't have emotion, we've seen it before. So it's great to see here, just an emotional farewell. Like I said, it works. And they did not, I don't think they added that in the manga, but it was a great touch in this episode. The music they played with the Worst Generation, I think they played the same one when Luffy delivered Red Hawk to Doflamingo with the assistance of Law. that Worst Generation music kicked in as soon as you see Carrot spot Sanji and Luffy. It's like, I can see Sanji, I can see Luffy, they're on the way. And everybody's like, even Jinbei in the background with a smile is like, yay, they did it, they're on the way. And that's just how the episode ends. But like I said, they're still not out of the woods yet, because they've got a sweet general on the, by the name of Smoothie on their heels. So I can't wait to see how that plays. Overwhelmingly, this was better than manga, easily. So let me know what you guys think down below. I thought it was a great episode. That's it from me. Thanks so much for watching. Like this review if you did. Subscribe to the channel for more One Piece. Catch you guys later. Bye.